Otro fucking estúpido, another stupid dumbass. This is motherfucking Nicky Jam, a Puerto Rican rapper, who was brought on stage by Donald Trump literally just now to go on stage and speak to the Latino community, particularly Puerto Ricans, and tell them to go vote for Donald Trump. The only fucking problem was, because his name is Nicky Jam, Donald Trump thought that he was a fucking woman.
Latin music superstar, Nicky Jam. Do you know Nicky? She's hot. Where is Nicky? Oh, look. Came up.
Okay, so he wildly fucking disrespected you by not knowing who the fuck you were and just bringing you up to pander to a specific group of people. But what exactly did you say when you got up there?
I'm gonna say this, but we need you. We need you back, right? We need you to be the president. Apart from that, I gotta say this in Spanish.
Dígalo.
Han pasado cuatro años y no ha pasado nada. Necesitamos a Trump. Let's make America great again.
So when he said, han pasado cuatro años y no ha pasado nada, he's basically saying 4 years have passed and nothing has happened. Well, Nicky Jam, let me fucking learn you something, bitch. Google is free and you can look at the White House. The bipartisan infrastructure law that the Biden-Harris administration was able to pass, the funding already provided $1.1 billion for dozens of infrastructure projects across Puerto Rico. That includes approximately $596 million for transportation, roads, bridges, public transports, ports, and airports, and $185 million for clean water. Biden also hosted the Puerto Rican Economic Dialogue to advance whole-of-government commitments to Puerto Rico, particularly those including small businesses. Mind you, this was in 2023 when the federal and territorial governments jointly implemented workforce development, infrastructure, energy, and resilience, building a diversified economy, and improving governance and data. To advance those actions, the Deputy Secretary Graves traveled to Puerto Rico in February of 2023 to meet with government, civic, academic, community, and private sector leaders. Biden-Harris administration also delivered unprecedented relief and made lasting investments for Puerto Rico's families, workers, municipalities, and businesses. Puerto Rico's territorial and 78 municipal governments received $4 billion in American Rescue Plan state and local fiscal recovery funds to respond to public health and economic impacts of the pandemic, of which Donald Trump fucking mishandled. Those historic investments included over $600 million to reward workers with bonus pay and $143 million to help local governments maintain essential services and keep police and firefighters on the fucking job. Biden also brought in the tax benefits to an unprecedented scale by expanding the child tax credit in Puerto Rico to all families with at least one child, permanently bringing the child tax credit benefits into parity with America. The average annual benefit was $4,700 per family, with more than $1.2 billion dispersed to families in Puerto Rico. He also delivered, with the rental assistance program, delivered $250 million in rent and utility assistance through December 2022, providing 244,000 payments to households in Puerto Rico facing the threat of fucking eviction. I mean, the list goes fucking on and on. This is a long-ass webpage. But I hope the fucking money was worth it, pendejo.